What's up, interwebs? My name is Cravel, and welcome back to Custom Hearthstone Concepts. For today's video, we had the art-inspired cards, of course, designed by the Discord server. And if you want to get in on the next video, we'll be announcing the theme at the end of this video, and there's a link to join the Discord in the description. For this video in particular, you guys actually kind of knocked it out of the park. We've got five cards for the video here from five different people, which is kind of incredible. I'm pretty happy with it. So, yeah, without further ado, let's just jump into it and see what we got to look at. Ready? Starting things off, we have a card by @FireTarask, which is Time Jump. It is a 3-mana priest spell, which reads, silence and destroy a minion. In 2 turns, resurrect it. And I really like this card. This card is a fun little trick there. So of course it is silence and destroy, so it is very anti-death rattle, which is a good thing. It can be used to kind of stall out if your opponent has played a big death rattle minion, keep it off the board for a bit. But also it's a very interesting card because you could also see this potentially being used in Resurrect Priest or in even like an OTK potentially. Honestly, the biggest thing that I like with this card is just how versatile it is and how simple of an effect it is, but just how many different angles there are to it. In a lot of ways, I think it's comparable to a more flexible Sap, where, you know, Sap is like a temporary removal of an enemy minion. This can be used as that, but it can also be used on your minions to bring them back in a couple of turns. And yeah, I really like the flexibility and especially the flavor on this. Again, that's a huge part of this video. And using card art that would have probably just been for a minion, using it for a spell like this, it fits really well with the art, and I'm really happy with it. I think it's a great card. Moving right along to the first of two legendary warlock minions, we have Thelmist, the 7-mana 4/7 dragon with Battlecry. Make a minion dormant. It awakens at the start of your next turn. And we actually saw quite a few cards that utilize Dormant for this video. For those of you who don't know, Dormant is used on several minions in like the adventure mode. It's used on the Nether portal that summons imps. Basically, it means that it counts as a minion, but it can't attack, it can't do anything, and it cannot be destroyed or removed in any way. So, again, this is kind of like a temporary removal. You could use it to silence a taunt, or you could use it to protect one of your minions, potentially. Make that minion dormant, and then it comes back the next turn so that your opponent can't attack that. Again, I just think this is a flexible minion. It's a bit interesting. In all honesty, I think it is a pretty weak card. I don't think that there's anywhere that this card would really fit in a deck, but it's just such a unique concept that I felt like I had to include it. It's a very unique idea, and it's a very, I feel, balanced use of the dormant mechanic, so. And of course, this card was made by Kyrie. They have been featured in a previous video. Yeah, great card, good stuff. Let's keep going. A couple people had the idea to focus on specific parts of the card art. This is actually something that you see in Hearthstone itself. I'll probably throw up an example of that if I remember to while editing, making extra work for myself here. But a lot of people did that with the image of Marad that we used there. Such as this card by Stockative, the 3-mana, 2/3 paladin weapon, Crystallizing Hammer. And we had a similar card to this in the previous video where it wasn't quite lifesteal, but it was a similar effect of sustaining yourself while swinging a weapon, where the card text here is, whenever your hero takes damage while attacking, instead convert that much health into armor. I think this card is extra interesting as we did see this type of thing kind of done with Thakal in the most recent Rastakhan's Rumble expansion, and I would love personally to see more effects like this. I think this type of armor switching makes for a really interesting mechanic. I do think that this might be a bit of a weird card balancing wise. It's not great at 3 mana, however it does effectively have immune while attacking, obviously not if you're within lethal range, but for most intents and purposes in the early game, this effectively is you are immune while attacking, but not only that, you can heal up. So The balancing on it is a bit weird, but I'm not sure if I personally could come much closer to a balanced card. I think this is a reasonable cost and stat line. And again, for the most part, I just loved the use of the card arts, focusing on a specific aspect there, as well as just the theming and the concept. I think it makes for an interesting card. And of course, as you may have gathered from some of my gameplay videos, I am a sucker for Heal Paladin, so another tool for that is obviously something that makes me happy, and yeah, overall I just really like this card. Let's keep going. Now, this card I'm including a lot more because of the aspect. Personally, I think that some of the stats should be changed on it, but I feel like it is a very interesting take on the Deathwing all-in mechanic. As you can see here, it's that Dragon Art. It is a Deathwing Legion Pact made by Heathen. It is a 10 mana, 12 attack, 20 health minion with Taunt, Elusive, Lifesteal, can't attack heroes, and Battlecry, discard your deck. I would also change the wording of that to destroy your deck, but overall this is a very interesting concept, and I kind of wanted to include it to expand upon it and kind of start talking about it. The idea of an all-in defensive minion I feel like is a really interesting concept to look at, especially in this concept where it's destroying your deck as opposed to just discarding your hand. Because yes, you do still have immediate options, but from there on in, your game plan is much, much, much more limited. I think it is a little bit broken because obviously right now we do have options in Standard that allow you to shuffle more cards into your deck, so to some degree that can be undone. And additionally, I feel like this specific iteration of it is a little bit too powerful. I would probably drop it to 12 attack, 12 health. I might honestly lose the lifesteal. I feel like that pushes it just that little bit into being too crazy. Overall though, I love this concept because it is so outlandish for what a legendary is. Most legendaries are these big, huge, you know, finishers. And when you do have legendaries that are defensive, you know, we're thinking like Azrak, Sagoth, they kind of suck. They're not good, they don't work well. But something like this, where it's got Elusive, which refers to, I'm sorry, I should have clarified this earlier, that refers to can't be targeted by spells or hero powers. So where you've got, you know, Elusive, Taunt, and just this massive health pool, I feel like there is some potential to really actually work out. But I don't know. I definitely would be interested in theory crafting this, seeing this in the game. But overall, not necessarily a good card, but just a very interesting card to look at. And yes, definitely good for this video. And lastly, we've got one more card that kind of focuses in on a specific point, yet another specific point of the Marad art. Insignia of Marad, which is a 4-mana spell. Give a minion in your hand Rush, Divine Shield, and Death Rattle. Cast this spell again. So this is kind of comparable to Explorer's Hat, and in that sense I feel like this might honestly be a little overcost, but as the designer, Justatuna, who we saw in the previous video, as they pointed out in the discussion, it's a little hard to balance because obviously that effect is much more comparable to the attack power of the minion. The other thing that has to be mentioned here is that unlike Explorer's Hat, the spell is cast again upon death of the minion, so it's just immediate, which again is much, much better, so I don't know, it's an interesting one. Effectively, what this would allow you to do is it would allow you to play a very control-heavy minion game where you cast this and then you play the minion that it's affecting and you're able to kind of trade up with your entire hand of minions as this spell reactivates over and over again. And it's definitely something that I would like to see in the game. I'm not too sure about the balancing. I'm not sure if this is a good card or a bad card, honestly. Honestly though, at the end of the day, this video's focus is much more on thematics, and the series' focus as a whole is on making interesting cards, unique cards, and undeniably this card is both. It is an interesting use of the card art, it is very thematic, and it's a very unique design. It's something that's interesting to look at, and and talk a little bit about, so. At any rate, I know that I kind of rushed through this video. Honestly, I love all of these cards, but there's not a ton to say on them. They're just solid cards, solid use of the card art, and yeah, I'm pretty happy with this video. Again, if you want to take part in the next one, you can go ahead and check the link in the description. And as you will probably see, there will be two channels open for the new video. The theme for this video is hero cards, but specifically, it is Rastakhan's Rumble. So the most recent expansion, we had the hero card for Zul'jin, and of course that was it. I want to see you guys make some more hero cards for it, so you can make them off of specific characters in the set, you can create new characters, you can do just the champions and what they would do as a hero card. I mean, heck, I personally did not like the Zul'jin hero card, so take the Zul'jin hero card and reimagine it, you know? That's absolutely something you can do, and I'm very much looking forward to the type of stuff that you guys present for that video. So, and once again, I hope you enjoyed this video. Lastly, of course, shout out to my patron, Dan the Chris, and if you like all the content on this channel, you can also support me. Link to the Patreon is also in the description below. Hope you guys enjoyed. Have a great day, everyone. Toodles.